पगड़ी। इतने में देखा कि अरे ये तो राक्षसी है, तो उस समय रामचंद्र जी ने लक्ष्मण से कहा
तो?
इससे ज्यादा छेड़छाड़ मत करो, इसको नाक कान काटो। तो इतने में लक्ष्मण जी ने उसका नाक कान कटवा दिया। नाक कान काट देने से अब विरूप हो गई, उसे कोई ग्रहण नहीं कर सका। असल में क्या है, राम रूप में तो उन्होंने स्वीकार नहीं की, बोले कि हम कृष्ण रूप में तुम्हें ग्रहण करेंगे, इसलिए उस जन्म में और किसी ने उसे नाक कान काट दिया, तो अभिरूप हो गया, अब कौन उसे ग्रहण करे। तो दूसरे जन्म में शूर्पणखा कुब्जा हो करके आई, और वो कुबड़ी थी। कुबड़ी होने के कारण बड़ी सुंदरी है, पर शादी नहीं हुई। कंस के दरबार में कंस राजा महाराजा कंस को तिलक लगाया करती है, अंगरा करती, यही उनकी सेवा थी। प्रतिदिन मंदिर कंस के दरबार में जाया करते। जब कृष्ण बलराम यहाँ अक्रूर के द्वारा मथुरा आए, तो उधार में वृंदावन दरवाजे पर डेरा तामो लक्षण कहने के लिए अंदर आए, तो आते ही पहले एक रजत मिला, जो कि गधे के पीठ पर राजपोशाक लेकर के जा रहे थे। उससे कपड़ा मांगा तो नहीं दिया, तो उसको ऐसे मारा तो उसका गला कट गया। फिर उससे कपड़े लिए, एक दर्जी से सिलवाया पहन लिए, एक मालाकार आ गए तो मालाकार से माला पहने, और फिर कुब्जा मिली तो कुब्जा से कहा अरे सुंदरी हमें अंगरा करा दोगी? तो बोले कि आप जैसे सुंदर पुरुष को अंगरा नहीं कराएंगे तो किसको कराएंगे। तब बड़े प्रसन्न हुए, उस समय उसने उसके पैर पर एक पैर दिया और एकदम सीधी हो गई। तो स्वर्ण से सुंदरी हो जाने से अब वो बड़ी सुंदरी बन गई। तो कृष्ण का कपड़ा पकड़ करके खींचने लगी कि आप मेरे घर चलिए। तो कृष्ण ने कहा पहले मैं कंस को मारूं, इसके बाद तुम्हारे पास आऊंगा। तो उसी वचन के लिए कृष्ण ने यहाँ पर कुब्जा के पास एक बार आया था, और यहीं पर उद्धव जी को साथ में लाए। तो कृष्ण एक बार कुब्जा से मिले थे, इसलिए श्रीमद् भागवत में वर्णन आता है कि कुब्जा के साथ एक बार तो कृष्ण का मिलन हुआ, और जाते समय कृष्ण से कहा कि हे वीर हे सुंदर, आप मेरे घर में यहाँ पर रहा करें, और यहीं पर आप विश्राम करें, यहीं पर आप आनंदित हों। परंतु कृष्ण और कभी आए नहीं लौट के। तो सुखदेव जी महाराज कहते हैं दुर्भाग्य ये तो मोचत। कुब्जा ने उनसे विषय सुख की रति सुख की प्रार्थना की, इसलिए कृष्ण नहीं आए। अब प्रेम की प्रार्थना करते तो जरूर आ जाते। तो गोपियों उलाहना देती है कि मथुरा में और कोई स्त्री नहीं मिली, केवल वही, इसलिए गोपियों के उष्ण का दर्शन होता है।
Kubja, beautiful Kubja, and Kavati has told us that Kubja is in her last life, he came as Shurpanakha, and that was in the pastime of Lord Ramchandra. When she approached Lord Ramchandra, she was very attractive to see the beauty of Lord Ram, so she wanted to marry him. So she came and she requested that if she can marry him, and he said, well, it's not possible because I have a vow that I will not take any other woman. I've just married once, and that's the vow for this lifetime. So maybe if you still want to marry, you can go and approach my younger brother Lakshman. He's also very handsome. So she went to Lakshman and she approached Lakshman, and Lakshman said, well, you're just fool, you know. If you become my wife, then you'll be working as a maid servant, whereas Sita is like queen. So you should go and try to become the queen. So she again went back to Lord Ram, and this time again Lord Ram refused. So like back and forth she went few times, and then she understood, oh, actually the cause of the whole problem is this Sita Devi. So I better kill her, and when she's not there, she's finished, then no problem. So when she was about to do that, Lord Ram, he indicated to Lakshman that he should quickly go and cut off her ear and neck, nose and ear, three parts. So Lakshman did that. Now, why he did that was because he accepted her feelings, Lord Ram accepted her feelings, but in that pastime he could not do so, and he would reciprocate with her when he will come in the form of Krishna. So that's why she came in the form of Kubja, and that was the place here when we have heard how Krishna Balaram was escorted to Mathura by Akrur, and when they came here, they met first that person who was washerman and they took clothes from him. Then he went to the tailor and the tailor made the proper size clothes for them. They wore them, and after that, when they were going around the city in different streets, Kubja was there and she was having her the sandalwood in her face, in her hand, and she was going to put the thumbs up. And Krishna and Baldev, and they said that you can give it to us. And when she offered them, they were very pleased by her offering. And then Krishna, he kept his one feet on her feet, and with his thumb he hold her on the chin and gave a big fist on her back, and she became straightened and became a very beautiful 16-year-old, nice, very beautiful girl. And as soon as she became like that, she hold on to the pitambar, the yellow garment with Krishna wears, and indicating she was inviting him to come and spend time in her waters. And Krishna said, okay, I'll do that, but first I must go and kill Kansa. So he went, and after killing Kansa, he came here. Later on, it is also said that she requested Krishna to stay here and as much time he can spend. But then he never came. So Prabhuji informed us that in Bhagavatam, Shukdev Goswami is telling the reason is that because she had the desire of sense pleasure in her heart, Krishna did not accept that. If she had desired for true love, with pure heart, she would have desired to serve Krishna for his pleasure, then Krishna would have accepted her. So that was a little bit malice there. So we should be also careful from this incident, and we should always make sure that our desires should completely stay pure, and we should just desire to serve the Lord for his pleasure, not for our pleasure. So we pray here at this place and mercy of this place, and we'll proceed further to our next
purpose.
Rangeshwar Mahadev.